Hi, is this Sirdar Beauty Bar?
Yes!
Come on in. Okay.
You want to get that face bridal ready months in advance for your big day. So we're just going to tell me exactly what we're doing today.
So today we are going to come up with a customized treatment plan for Shivani. We are going to treat her as if she's a bride who's getting prepared for her big day.
There's no ring on
this. Yet. Not yet. So usually what we do is we start with a skin analysis. We go in with a double cleanse, and based off of your skin type, we come up with a customized treatment plan just to work off of your skin.
Alright, this sounds so exciting and I'm so ready to get started.
Yes!
Stay tuned! And
yes.
I'm just glowing.
You look amazing, by the way.
And I'm not wearing makeup right now, so everything is like fully natural, and it was just so amazing. Thank you guys so much.
No problem. Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
All right, so we're gonna start off the conversation with the question I like to ask everyone. What does being Indo-Caribbean mean to you?
You ask the right people. We love Guyana. We're brown and proud.
We're canal gals. I don't know if you've ever heard of that.
Never heard of that.
You don't know?
No. Oh, is that a reality TV show? Should be.
Yeah. Well, our family, they're Guyanese. We're from Guyanese descendant. And we, unlike regular American kids that got to go to camp, my mom shipped us off to Guyana in the summer, and we loved it.
Oh, everyone thinks that we were born in Guyana, how much we love Guyana.
Yeah.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, like, when everybody was, like, camping, we were, like, helping my aunt hatch chickens and ducks, and, like, it really cultured us. So we love being brown. We love other brown people, and we're all for, like, brown girls who, like, inspire other brown girls.
Yeah. So Indo-Caribbean definitely just means culture.
Culture,
like, you're not here for the culture.
Yeah. And I definitely think it's a mixture, like, our specific community is such a mixture of, like, having this Indian side, but then also having this Caribbean culture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's just, it's amazing. So, actually, I just wanted to go into, like, skincare. So, I noticed that in the community itself, I noticed a lot of, you know, makeup artists, hair artists, but I never really seen, like, skin. So I definitely can say that you guys took a very huge stride or step in pioneering in this community.
Well, thank you for that.
Yeah,
that's amazing to hear, because we have prided ourselves on skin for not just like our brown community, but like for skin and for everybody. It is amazing to see the confidence people have when they're able to be barefaced, and like how they feel after a dermaplan, and like how they feel when they do their makeup. So our focus is just to make sure everybody is happy and confident within themselves. In the brown community, we love meeting with people and like connecting and networking. We've met a lot of people through facials, and we travel a lot, so we're in Queens a lot.
I do have to say that Indo-Caribbean like people, they have been like our number one supporters since we opened our business.
Which is amazing, like your own people supporting you, it's like a beautiful thing.
It is.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I'm definitely so proud of you.
Oh my god,
for making that step, because I definitely think the community needs it.
Like you said, there's a bunch of makeup artists, hair artists, but there's nobody that focuses on skin like we do.
And that's kind of why we wanted to start it, because we do think that even if you get your makeup done and someone can try to make you as flawless as you want to look, but you will feel that confidence from within when you know your skin is good underneath.
Yes, and I definitely think you guys get it. Like, you guys get our skin type.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that anyone out there doesn't get the skin type,
right.
But it's just like, you guys understand it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I'm going to ask a question.
Yay!
So what are your favorite Indo-Caribbean foods?
Oh my god,
chicken
curry and rice. My favorite.
I like Karaila. I love Karaila.
What?
Yeah!
I like Karaila
so
too.
So bitter!
I like
so
all
good.
Three.
And it's
Fora,
so good for
Baji, squash, Belange, all of them my favorites. I could eat all. But
she's the pickiest one.
I'm not that picky.
Like the pickiest eater. She doesn't like
well,
dolls. She doesn't like
chana. She doesn't like doll. She doesn't like chana.
She doesn't like goat.
But when she was younger, she really liked goat.
I'm just going to ask something that we're probably all wondering. Who's the oldest, youngest, and middle child?
We're all sitting in order. I know I may look the youngest, but I'm the oldest. Then Stephanie, and then our little baby, Chelsea.
Aww. All right, so fun facts about each of you. Go. Starting.
Fun fact about me. I don't know. Am I fun? I don't know.
Okay, well, how about you guys tell me a fun fact about her?
Okay.
Fun fact about Mal is that she's boring.
Yeah, like she'll be like the hype man. Like,
I am
the hype
man.
We're gonna do this, we're gonna do that.
And then we'll be at the event and she'll be like,
no, like I'll make the shots and then I'll take them and then I gotta go to sleep.
Oh
so it's like,
God.
I'm tired. I like to have fun and I like everybody to have fun. And then I can go to sleep.
Like, I'm tired.
Fun fact about Stephanie, everyone thinks she's the most quiet, but she's not.
Yeah, everyone thinks she's nice.
But she's not.
But I am.
She's nice, but she's like, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, fun fact about me.
Well,
I'm very artsy and creative. Like, I've always had that in me since I was younger.
Yeah, she loves art.
Yeah, I love art. I love to paint. I haven't painted in a while, but that used to be, like, my
thing. Yeah, my Steph actually painted a picture of a pit bull, and my aunt loved it so much that she got
it
for her dog.
An animal shelter.
Oh, yeah. She put it in her doggy's room, so it's, like, really cute.
Yeah, so, like, I'm really into art and things like that.
That's nice. So nice.
Yeah.
And it just so happened that we happen to be in, like, an art studio. So just
yeah,
walking in here, it's like you're in an art gallery.
Yeah,
so this is, like, amazing.
All right, what about me, guys?
Fun fact about Chell, our parents still treat her like she's a little baby.
Fun fact about her, her name was supposed to be Kimberly.
Oh yeah, I wanted to name her Kimberly, the pink Power Ranger, not Kardashian. You know what I mean? But I was like, yeah, mom, I wanted her name to be Kim. She's actually named after Chelsea Clinton.
Oh wow.
My parents love the Clintons.
Why did Chelsea get like the best like fun fact?
Yeah, thing? You guys told me I'm boring.
You guys are saying like, come on,
fun fact is I'm the best. That's what I was gonna say. The fun fact is I'm the best. I'm the coolest to hang around. I can name.
Oh god, here we go. The fun fact about Steph, I would say like nice fun fact. Like she's a really good gift giver. I think nice. She gives like good gifts, and she's like a Sagittarius, so she's very bougie. So she gives like
the bougie gifts.
Oh, and fun fact, she always brings some coffee.
Wait,
yeah.
which is me. Okay.
She gets free Starbucks at her job, so you know.
Okay, so who fights the most?
Us two. The two of us.
Sips really? Tea.
No, I mean, the two of us fight, like, on our, like, daily, but we get over it. But when, like, the two of them fight, even though I'm the oldest, I can't, like, get a word in to tell them to stop. Like, they would never.
But Chelsea's, like, the one that kind of, like, grounds everybody. Like, we'll be up here and she'll take us to, like...
And then we'll, like, right spike here. Back up.
And then we'll go back up. And then we're, like... Okay, and then back up. Yeah.
Yes, it's. Honestly, like we can fight and it can be really bad, and then someone walks right through our door and boom, you wouldn't be able to tell.
It's like back to business.
So
like,
before we even opened this business, we all worked together in a nursing home. I'm a nurse. Steph, she does like IT and management, and Chell was in lifestyle. So we all like have experience like fighting and working together, and also just like diffusing it and going to work. So
nice.
It's hard being sisters because at the end of the day we can say whatever to each other, but
I think it is harder to be in business with like a relative than it is with a stranger, because you have that comfort zone with someone you're so close with, so you do feel like you can't say anything and reject anything you want to say out to the universe. As opposed to a stranger,
you kind of watch what you say, and you
kind of don't want to be this way, and you think about it. Mm-hmm. But when it's a relative, you don't care. You're just like whatever.
Yeah. But also, what's good about that is that we'll never like leave each other's side. Like we can fight and whatever, and we always make up. So I guess like that's the good part. We always
next question was it hard to work as sisters?
Yeah. Yeah. It definitely is hard to work as sisters. Sometimes it's really good, sometimes it's really bad.
We barely agreed on picking the color for the room.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so
things. So because it's three, sometimes two of us are on the same page and one of us isn't, or like all three of us are on separate different pages.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
And it's like three opinions, three girls.
But I wanted this.
When I have three, like, you have three now.
So I definitely was gonna say, here's this question in my mind. Working as sisters, so like when you guys go home, is it annoying to see each other every day?
No, we actually, it's so crazy. People think we're always together all the time because we have this business, but we're not. So like when we do have like time as sisters to hang out, we love it. Like we're able to brainstorm, we're able to like do things. We do hang out on like a everyday basis, I would say, but there's times where like I'm so tired from today, please just, I want to watch Netflix alone.
Yeah. As weird as it is, we don't really get to hang out alone, because when we're here, we are here with people and things like that. Mm-hmm. And then when we leave, like, we all have significant others.
She's married, she doesn't live with us anymore. Oh. Yeah. But she lives across the street, so we go and hang out at her
literally
house.
Wow. Right, directly across the street.
Yeah. That's definitely perfect. So we actually have two brides.
Well, we have a married lady here.
Yes, we have a married lady, but she also is a bride as well.
Yes, she's a bride.
I'll be getting married next year.
Are you excited?
I am. I'm excited and nervous, but more so excited.
I'm excited, yeah.
I'm excited. We're excited.
It's like our first like grand like event for our family.
So. I do think it's amazing that Siobhan will be covering your wedding.
Yes,
I will be.
Of course.
I feel like just the whole aspect of what you're doing is so brilliant.
Our community needs it. It really does.
And I cannot wait for your wedding. I love Indo Caribbean weddings, obviously. I'm obsessed with them. I cannot wait so much.
Thank
you. Are you taking care of your skin?
Yes. Of course, I have. I love it. Yes, I've been on a skincare journey for how many years now?
A while. Yeah, they all have beautiful skin, like, no joke.
I'm working on my skin. I'm trying to look young forever.
I see nothing, like, on your skin that I can talk about. Like, it's beautiful.
Thank you.
We also do have another bride to be.
Yes, thank you. I just recently got engaged, so I'm, like, in the planning process. It's not as fun as everyone thinks it is.
Yeah, I can definitely vouch for that.
I thought I would have been more prepared and I would have like known what to do, but I'm just like every day I change my mind and Chelsea's tired of me. She's like, Mom, make your mind up today, please.
It's like the same with both of them, and I always just try to say like if it makes you lose your peace of mind, just don't let it
it's
ruin your
so
peace
crazy.
Of mind.
Before like I got like engaged or married or anything like that, like I had this vision of like what I wanted my wedding to look like, how I wanted things
to be.
Remember? I wanted this, I wanted that, and like now, like when it's like for real, I'm like, oh my god, do I need this? Do I want this? Like panicking, like I don't know what I want. Like my head is just all.
It's hard to
this.
Make decisions.
Yeah, because it's like this is for real now. Like this is not just, you know.
And it's crazy because like a lot of her vendors and things that she's going with, all the other businesses are Indo-Caribbean as well.
Yeah. So I'm trying to keep it, you know, in our culture.
Yes. I feel like it's just given because we all support each other, so just why not, you know?
I'm so excited for you.
Thank you.
I'm excited too. Yeah. Is there anything that Indo-Caribbean Bride Magazine can do to help you?
I just need you guys to be there. Yeah. I just need you there, that's all.
Okay, I cannot wait. So I have some fun questions for you guys. Favorite Bollywood songs?
I love Meri Mehboob Meri Sanam is my favorite,
yes,
like all time.
Too.
And I love like the video of like the girl coming in and like out and he's like confused and drunk. That's like my favorite.
Can we like sing a little bit about it?
Okay. Guys, can you play it so I don't...
Okay,
are you
gonna
sing with me?
So we sing on this magazine, guys.
You guys, I don't need it.
Meri Mehboob Meri Sanam
Shukriya Meherbani Karam or something.
I have no idea.
I thought that was really good. Shah Rukh Khan would be impressed.
You don't
my
know how
song.
Obsessed I am with Shah Rukh Khan. Like,
I love him.
What? You
yeah.
met Shah Rukh
Khan? He was on her
rooftop.
Yeah,
she met him.
Rooftop. He has a lot of filler.
He does a lot of what?
Filler. Like, he does a lot of work on his face.
But I love him.
Face.
I don't care. And he smokes a cigarette.
I don't care. That's
I know.
Bae. Oh yeah. Next
there was
time
like a
you
line.
See a celebrity, can you tell me?
It was crazy because it was like a rooftop in the city, and there was like a line for like only girls to like go see him.
Yeah.
And I was like, sorry, babe, gotta go, right?
Oh,
and
oh my god.
It was kind of like a you meet him, you hug him, and you gotta go. There's a girl behind
There's
you.
There's no pictures.
Like, no. The security guards were like pushing everybody out. I was drunk. I sent a picture of like where his VIP section was to them.
Yeah.
They're like, we don't see him. I'm like, he's there though.
Did he
like,
say anything to you?
No, he just hugged me and like that was it. I was like,
that's
I'm so your cool. biggest fan. And he
yeah,
was
he's
like,
probably,
he's like, yeah,
I'm
like,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
yeah.
But I think he felt it when I said it.
Oh my god. I feel you. On that.
Yeah, he's so dreamy. He's short though. Let me stop talking about him.
I can talk about him all day.
Me too.
All day. Anyway, sorry. What is
it's okay.
your favorite Bollywood?
Mine is Bolachudiya.
Oh.
Yes. I used to think I was on
Critical Core.
Yeah. In the video. I used to, when I was younger, I used to really want to
So
be
you were Pooh?
I was Pooh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Guys, I don't know what Come on, favorite song.
You don't have a favorite song?
I don't think I have a favorite. I like love them all.
No,
yeah.
Steph, you have to choose.
Here's one thing that I like to do. Like, when you think about your wedding, which song pops in your head?
So many.
Like
all at once.
Yeah, so many.
You know why? We were hanging out with our cousin the other day, and she was playing a mix, and she's like, Stephanie, you need all these songs at your wedding.
And I was like, you know what this sounds like? This sounds like the music that they play when you're just sitting down and waiting.
Yeah.
It sounds like sit down, waiting, like trying to
waiting
get
waiting for the wedding to start. Yeah.
The, that song. Love, but the...
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh my god,
I love
that
one.
Yeah. Oh my god. I love Priyanka.
Yeah. My next question was going to be, who is your favorite?
We keep beating you to
all
of
them. Yeah, I don't know how.
We're like two steps ahead of you.
I love Priyanka, and I love Nick, and I love that he married a brown girl, because I loved him, and I was like, I'm gonna marry him. So I feel like he knew the vibe.
Can I ask you a question?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay, team Ronnie or Kajol?
Kajol.
Kajol all day.
Yeah,
I love
Kajol.
She's funny.
She's funny, she's quirky.
Yeah.
And she
yeah.
still posts on the
so
gram.
Much personality.
Yeah. Not that I don't like Ronnie, but it's
yeah.
just Kajol's
yeah.
surprising.
Yeah.
And I grew up with her, like, watching Kush. And I love Shah Rukh Khan.
Yeah.
So, like, them together.
You think them two together versus Ronnie and him?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, me
not
too.
A Tina person.
Oh, my God! I love Tina. I used to fight when I was little. Am I Tina today or am I Anjali? Like, I don't know.
Did you tell me your favorite color?
My apple one, guys. What's my... If you guys would know, like... What would you think my favorite song is? I don't know.
No, we're on Bollywood Star, right?
Yeah.
Bollywood
Star? Oh no, my favorite star, obviously besides Shah Rukh Khan. Girl star?
Yes. Actress.
Yeah, Kajol.
Kajol?
Kajol and Ronnie.
So we have to pick girl, because my favorite actor, I correct myself, Amitabh Bachchan. He's my favorite.
Wow.
I love him.
Classic.
Yeah. Classic. My mom loves him too.
I like Topeka.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love Topeka. I also think my cousin looks like her.
Really?
Yeah, my cousin Shanice, she just got married last year, and she looks like Topeka. Even her husband thinks so.
Oh, nice.
She does. She does look like her, yeah.
She's like,
yeah.
So I was just going to ask.
They kind of have like that same like vibe too. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was going to say, between Topeka's style look, like beauty, like icon look, have you seen Priyanka? Who would you rock?
I think Priyanka. I love Topeka, and I love her simplicity. I feel like she has her own aura. But me personally, like, they're probably gonna have different opinions. I'm like more fun. Like, I like funky colors and like fun things, and I feel like
Mal loves to put on a funky earring or something like that, and just brighten up her entire outfit.
Yeah.
Okay. I have a bonus question.
Yes.
Nyla Blackman or Shinsia?
Shinsia.
No, but I love Nyla. Like, I hate that you made me pick.
Yeah,
I like Shinsia.
Yeah.
I love Shinsia.
Yeah. I would love to go see her.
She's amazing.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Dal and rice
or dal and bhaji?
Dal and rice.
Can I have dal, rice, and bhaji? Or no?
Dal, rice, and bhaji.
That's me. That's what I'm trying to have.
Okay, dal puri or bus up shot?
Bus up shot.
Ooh, my boyfriend's
not a dal puri kind of girl.
Bus up.
I love dal puri and sour.
Mama's gonna be disappointed when she sees this. She's gonna be like, y'all did not say dal puri.
Sorry, mama. I'm still with the bus up shot.
Okay. Bus up shots are
What about you? What do you like more?
I actually bus up shot probably. Oh, I like a lot of Trinidadian.
We love doubles.
Yeah. Doubles.
Chow.
So my fiance is half Trini and his mom makes like bacon shark and like nice. I love the tamarind sauce.
Now
it's
I'm
so
hungry.
Great.
Okay. And last one before we close off. What are you most excited for the Battle magazine coming out?
Honestly, everything. I feel like you have been doing a phenomenal job ever since I met
our
you.
Our girl's been working.
You.
I'm just so happy you did this for the community and like to shed a little light on our culture, because not a lot of people know about, like, people ask me, like, what are you? I say I'm Guyanese, and they're like, oh, you're African, or where is that?
Oh,
or
you're
things
from
like
Ghana.
That. Yeah, so it's like
Ghana
shedding,
yeah.
It's shedding a light to our community and like the different businesses and things that like we do, and it's just amazing.
Thank
so,
you so
we're
much.
Just so happy that
Actually,
you're doing this.
I always tell you how I feel about it.
Yeah.
So it's brilliant.
No, I love them.
This
so
is
much.
Like brilliant. So brilliant.
You. And like what would a community be without you guys as our vendors? So
oh
I,
God,
that's
so
why it's like all about us, you know?
Yeah.
So thank you so much.
Thank you
for having so much fun today.
Yeah, it was so fun. We're so honored to have you here and like covering us and our weddings and all of that. We're just
I can't.
So
let's
excited.
Cheers.
Let's cheers, guys. Yeah.
Cheers.
So good to
Not
cheers. All right, 3, 2. Hi, is this Sirdar Beauty Bar?
No, it's Patrick.
That is so funny. Okay, I'm ready. So who's the oldest?
Yes.
Who do you think?
I think it's you.
Yeah, we're standing in order. We're standing in birth order.
This middle baby.
How is it like being a middle child? Because like
it's true, middle child syndrome. No. Middle child
syndrome? No, I'm the last child.
She's
okay,
the most
spoiled.
Baby.
Spoiled.
That's
really?
To be honest, Chuck, what do you think? I think Steph is not a regular middle child. She's like a spoiled middle child.
No.